सदाशिवसमारंभां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमवस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण्विजातिपुरं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहतिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे The next adhikarana is the Saptagati adhikarana. It is introduced by Indi Vritti by saying, Itham Indriyanam Utpattim Prasadhya. Tebhyo Jivasya Vivekartham Tad Ashrita Sankhyam Nirnetu Kamaha Ashraya Ashri Bhava Sangatya Itamaha. The Bhautika Indriyas are also born from Brahma, this was established. So having established that, Prakarshena Sadhya, what is that? Indriyanam Utpattim, from Brahma. Tebhya Jivasya Vivekartham Tad Ashrita Sankhyam Nirnetu Kamaha. So these Indriyas are to be used for what purpose? Basically, they are Karanas. But for a mumukshu, they are to be used for sadhana. So vivekartham, buddhi, antakkarana, primarily a connect between the inside and the outside world, a gateway to the outside world rather. That antakkarana, which plays the role of buddhi also, should be used for viveka. So Indriyashrita Sankhya, Tadashrita is Indriya, Tad is Indriya. So Tebhya Indriyabhya Jivasya Vivekartham, these Indriyas, how many are there? So Indriyas are to be used as Karana, and then it is to be the Jivasya Vivekartham. So Tadashrita meaning Indriyashrita Sankhya. How many are Indriyas basically? Indriyashrita Sankhya means how many Indriyas are there? So Tad Nirnetu Kamaha. Tad Ashrita Sankhyam Nirnetu Kamaha. Ashre Ashre Bhava Sangatya Idamaha. So Sutrakara is Nirnetu Kamaha. He is desirous of ascertaining what Sankhya. Tad Ashrita Sankhyam. The number which is Tadashrita is, that number is there in the Indriyas. The way the Tarkika would say, Tadashrita Sankhya. So if Indriyas are 7, then 7 will be the number in Indriyas. So you have to identify how many Indriyas are there, because there is variety of numbers discussed in the Shastra. So Purvapakshi says that these are 7, or someone will ascertain it is 7. 10, 8, so various numbers are there. So you have to identify which are these Indriyas and what is the real number. Thereby, Tadashrita Sankhyam Nirnetu Kamaha Ashraya Ashri Bhava Sangatya Idamaha. Between the earlier Adhikarana and this Adhikarana, there is a Ashraya Ashri Bhava Sangati. This Adhikarana is dependent on the earlier, because earlier Adhikarana said that established that Indriyas are born from Brahma. So now this Adhikarana continues with dependency in the earlier as to, okay, how many are the Indriyas now? Thereby Saptagati Adhikaranam. Saptagater Visheshitattvaccha. Saptagater Visheshitattvaccha. So this is an Ekadeshi Sutra. When the Purvapakshi asks how many Indriyas are there, these Indriyas which are born from Brahma, how many are those? So there the एकदेशी सिद्धांती, एकदेशी वेदांती, विच इज नॉट अ परम सिद्धांत, दैट ही एजर्ट्स एज टू देर आर सेवन सप्त. वाई? गते हे, गते हे अवगते हे, बिकॉज देर इज सच एन अंडरस्टैंडिंग वेन यू लुक एट दी शास्त्र. वाई? विशेषतत्वाच्च, देर इज अ पर्टिक्युलर विशेष विच हैज बीन मेन्शन देर. सो सप्त गते हे विशेषितत्वात् च, दीज आर दी फोर पदाज इन दी सूत्र, दैट इज अ पदच्छेद. सो वॉट इज ही सेइंग रियली? इंद्रियाणां सप्त गते हे, सप्तत्व अवगते हे, एंड वॉट? विशेषितत्वाच्च, देर इज अ विशेषण गिवन एज टू वेर आर दीज इंद्रियाज एंड हाउ मेनी आर दोज. सो सप्त इज वन नंबर विच इज मेन्शन, एंड दे हैव टू बी सेवन बिकॉज these indriyas are said to be in the in the area that the face covers. So it is the head covers, rather the head has these seven indriyas. This is the discussion. So he says due to two hetus. One is sapta number itself has been given, and shirshanyatvena visheshitatvaccha. These indriyas are discussed in the shastras as being in the head, in the area of the head. Therefore, they are to be seven. So these are the hetus he gives. So what are these really? If you look at it, it will come up in the vritti. So we'll see more in the vritti. Sapta pranaha bhavanti tasmat. इति इंद्रियाणि सप्त संकीर्त्यन्ते. देयर इज अ श्रुति विच से सप्त प्राण, एंड वी हैव सीन प्राणः समटाइम्स इट कैन मीन इंद्रिया, समटाइम्स इट कैन मीन मुख्य प्राण, समटाइम्स इट कैन मीन दी प्राण भेद, प्राण अपान व्यान उदान समान, और समटाइम्स इट कैन मीन प्राण इटसेल्फ मीन ब्रह्म. एंड जस्ट टू रीविजिट दी सूत्र दैट वी कवर्ड यस्टरडे, तथा प्राणः, देयर दिस प्राणः इज इन इंद्रिया सेंस. सो दिस the word prana, pranaha, it is plural, so it cannot be mukhya prana, it cannot be in brahma meaning. I mean if you just take the plural, so what can it be? It can mean indriyas, or it can mean pancha pranas, the prana bhedas. Now in the shruti itself it is etasma jayate pranaha manaha sarvendriyani cha, indriyani cha shabda is there, therefore in the shruti the prana shabda can be prana, that has to be discussed. It is still not clear as to what that word prana means, but prana in the sutra means indriyas. But the vritti said indriya utpatti shrute, so the etasma jayate pranaha manaha sarvendriyani cha, their pranaha manaha and indriyas, all those are basically karanas. And then there are bhutas which are talked about. So all the bhautikas are covered in the first half of the mantra, Mundaka mantra, and the bhutas are covered in the panchamaha bhutas are covered in the next half, second half of the Mundaka mantra. So pranaha manaha sarvendriyani cha etasma jayate, etasma brahmana jayate. So we saw that yesterday. But there may be some confusion as to pranaha means indriyas, but indriyas also mentioned there. So there you can say this word pranaha in the sutra talks about indriyas, but in the mantra prana and sarve indriyani are there, indriyani, their indriyas are in there, meaning swartha meaning indriyas, but prana is also in swartha meaning. Prana does not mean indriya there, need not mean, because sarve indriyani are counted separately. Therefore, we can just see that all put together it is called as Indriya Utpatti Shrutihi, and all of them are Karanas, and thereby you can see as they are like Indriyas. So they are Indriyas, and we saw that Pranaha, without Pranas Karmendriyas won't work, the Jnanendriyas also won't be engaged in their own Golakas. At least Karmendriyas you can take that without Prana, Prana Vayu, what we say prana vayu, vayu rupa prana, not the vayu which is there outside, but the prana is also with the divisions you can see it is the panchabhedas do their work. So at least you know, the prana apana, the prana bheda, in prana apana, inhalation, exhalation, at least you can feel the stula rupa of vayu. The other three may be sukshma, which, you know, circulate nourishment or help digestion or, you know, throw out something undesired by, or in mrityu also they help the jiva leave the sharira, udana. So all these different vayus may be subtle, but the prana apana, inhalation and exhalation, you feel it, that it is vayu rupa. So you can feel the, it is slightly grosser than the other three, stula. So thereby this prana can be seen as, without its functioning, the indriyas won't function. At least karmendriyas, you can feel that. The karmendriyas, when pranas are lacking, then the karmendriyas become weaker. You cannot act out. With shallow breathing, you do not have enough energy to move the karmendriyas. And why karmendriyas? Jnanendriyas also, without prana being active, your breathing goes, becomes shallow. Meaning it is not shallow by pranayama in the sense it is contained, but what has happened is that it's like a disease where you are having difficulty breathing. Then it is very easy to see that indriyas try to fold back from vishayas and they become weak. You don't feel like, you know, engaging any, not only in any activity which is physical, but also mental activity, as to, you know, the indriyas going out. You don't feel like, you know, if you are a movie buff, somebody says, you know, let's watch a movie, you are having difficulty breathing, you cannot watch a movie. You don't feel like it. Because indriyas are weak, they'll, you know, you'll feel sleepy. So with all that, you can see these karanas, indriyas, so there is an overlap there. Mana is antakarana, sarvendriyani anyway are karanas, and prana is also karana there. Thereby it is indriyotpatti shruti. However, the word prana in the mantra and in the sutra need not mean the same. It is that prana need not have the same meaning. So I just want to clarify, because perhaps yesterday that point was left out. I said that prana word can have various meanings, but where is it, in which meaning, that we have to see in the tatparya. So that tatparya will unfold as we go. The same mantra will be, you know, revisited. So with that background, the saptagate visheshi tattva. So how many are these indriyas now? So there, the ekadeshi Vedanti has said that they are seven, because they are in the area of the head and they are counted as seven in the Shruti. So sapta pranaha bhavanti. Here pranaha, this word pranaha plural is in the meaning of indriyas now. So sapta pranaha bhavanti means sapta indriyani prabhavanti. Prabhavanti tasmat. Not bhavanti, prabhavanti. So they are born from Brahma basically. Iti indriyani sapta sankirtyante. They are very well mentioned there as seven. Which are these seven really? So pancha jnanendriyani, and then vak and manaha. So five jnanendriyas which help you grasp the vishayas, shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha. So specifically shrotrendriya, then for shabda, for sparsha tvagendriya, then shabda sparsha rupa, for rupa chakshurendriya, then rasendriya for jala, and then for taste, and gandhavati prithvi, for that vishaya grahana you need ghranendriya. So these are the five jnanendriyas. Then vak, the rasanendriya is in the tongue and vak is also in the tongue. There are two indriyas. The tongue functions as the input as well as output. It helps you taste also and it helps you speak. So vagendriya also, which is karmendriya. So that is another vak, and then manaha, antakkarana. So these are seven. So sapta prana pravanti tasmatiti indriyani sapta sankirtyante kutra shrutau eva sakshat shruti. So this is what the ekadeshi Vedanti points out. Then he says there are seven at one place. Purva Pakshi says, oh, there are eight elsewhere. Sometimes they are counted as nine, sometimes as, you know, 10, sometimes 11. So he says, kvachid ashtau, kvachin nava, kvachid dasha, क्वचित एकादश. सो नॉट ओनली आर देयर सेवन इन दी श्रुति बट समटाइम्स एट एल्सवेयर नाइन टेन. सो इफ यू ऐड हस्तश्च यू नो इफ यू ऐड दी हस्तेन्द्रिय दिल बिकम एट टू दी अर्लियर सेवन. इफ यू एंड इन गीता नवद्वाराणि नाइन आर टॉक्ड अबाउट. सो यू ऐड कीप ऑन एडिंग यू विल गेट टेन इलेवन. सो क्वचित दश क्वचित एकादश इति एवं सप्तत्व अष्टत्वादि संख्याश्रुतीनां परस्पर विरोधोस्ति न वा इति संदेहे अस्ति इति पूर्वपक्षः. सो पूर्वपक्षी सेज डेफिनेटली देयर इज अ विरोध बिकॉज इफ यू कीप ऑन काउंटिंग यू विल सी दैट समवेयर यू नो दीज वेरियस नंबर्स सेवन एट नाइन टेन इलेवन. सो हाउ कैन इट बी दैट इंद्रियाज आर सेवन and ranging till 11. So there is definitely paraspara virodha between all these shrutis. Iti evam. In this manner, saptatva ashtatva adi. Saptatva ashtatva are opposed to each other. Ityadi sankhya shruti naam. The shruti which gives such sankhyas for indriyas, paraspara virodha. Mutually they are opposed to each other. Whether such opposition is there, contradiction is there or not. Paraspara virodha astinava iti sande. When such doubt is there, Purvapakshi says definitely there is a virodha. एकदेशी सिद्धांत सेज इति पूर्वपक्ष और इति पूर्वपक्षे सति. व्हेन द सच पूर्वपक्ष इज प्राप्त एज टू देर इज विरोध. एकदेशी वेदांति सेज एकदेशी सिद्धांत सप्तेन्द्रियाणि दे आर सेवन. वाई कुतः गते है बिकॉज श्रुति इज देर. गते है श्रुत्या सप्तत्व अवगते है बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सप्त प्राण प्रभवन्ति तस्मात् ब्रह्मणः. Therefore, the Sapta word is there in the Shruti. And elsewhere what? Sapta vai shirshanya pranaha iti shirshanyatvena visheshatatvaccha. Another Shruti is there which also says Sapta vai. Indeed, there are seven. And Saptatva avagate. That becomes a hetu. Saptatva understanding is there from the earlier mantra also. And there is another vakya in the Shruti which says Sapta vai shirshanyaha pranaha. Prana, Indriyas, how many are there? Indriyani, Saptavai, indeed they are seven. And where are they? They are Shirshanya, Shirsa Sambandhi. So they are in the area of the head. So therefore, there is no reason to discount the number seven. It is repeated and that is the Vishesha. Specifically, it has been mentioned in a particular area. Therefore, सेवेन आर देर. अष्टत्वादि संख्या वॉट अबाउट दैट एट नाइन टेन इलेवन सच नंबर्स आर ऑल्सो देर एल्सवेयर. वॉट अबाउट दैट आज दि पूर्व पक्षी टू दैट एकदेश सिद्धांति से अष्टत्वादि संख्या श्रवणं तु एकस्यैव अंतःकरणस्य वृत्तिभेदाभिप्रायम् इति न श्रुतीनां विरोध इति. ही सेज एट नाइन टेन इलेवन वी कैन जस्ट कीप ऑन एडिंग बेस्ड ऑन विच आर दि वृत्तिज इन दि अंतःकरण. सो यू ऐड बुद्धि यू ऐड मन रोल ऑफ अंतकरण तो सेम अंतकरण अष्टत्वादि संख्या एकस्यैव अंतकरण से वन अंतकरण प्लेज द रोल ऑफ मन ऑल्सो चित्त ऑल्सो बुद्धि ऑल्सो अहंकार ऑल्सो. सो यू कीप ऑन एडिंग दोज यू विल गेट एट नाइन टेन इलेवन ऑल दीज नंबर्स. सो यू स्टार्ट विथ सेवन देन यू ऐड वन यू गेट एट मीनिंग द अंतकरण प्लेज द रोल ऑफ फोर. सो यू कीप ऑन एडिंग वन वन ईच सो यू विल गेट 4, 8, 9, 10, 11. So these numbers are included as vritti bheda of the antakkarana itself. Therefore, there is no virodha at all, says the Purvapakshi, says the ekadeshi Vedanti to the Purvapakshi. Tad ekadeshi matam dushayati. Now that ekadeshi mata is not paramasiddhant, that is not the correct meaning rather. So therefore, ekadeshi is also Purvapakshi to परम सिद्धांति एंड देयर बाय दि सूत्रकार से हस्तादयस्तु स्थिते यतो नैवम. हस्तादयस्तु स्थिते तो नैवम. दिस इज हस्तादयः तु स्थिते अतः न एवम न एवम. इन दिस मैनर द वे इन विच यू हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड सेवन इंक्लूड ज्ञानेन्द्रिय वागेन्द्रिय एंड मनः एंड देन यू ऐड वृत्ति भेद ऑफ दि मनः. सो देयरफॉर यू विल बी काउंटिंग ओनली the jnanendriyas and maybe one vagendriya, but what about the other hastendriya ityadi? they are not, you know, karma indriyas are not there in your count at all. Because if you add the vritti bheda of antakkarana, you will still be in the area of the jnanendriyas and antakkarana, but then karmendriyas are still left out and they are mentioned in the shruti. Therefore, your 7 number and 11 number, both you explain by saying only 7 are there and the others are by vritti bheda, that won't work. Hastadayaha. Therefore, hasta, pada, all these are there. Thereby, the hastadeha tu is in the sense of api, or ekadeshi mata nirasartha. Tuhu, ekadeshi mata nirasartha, says the vritti. So, hastadeha tu stite sati. Meaning, the purvapakshi has asked how many indriyas are there. So, there is another shruti that can be looked into. As to when the indriyas are having a debate among themselves, indriya devatas really, abhimani devatas, adhishtatru devatas. So we have seen this in Chandogya. There is a discussion as to who is the main indriya, who is the main among all these indriyas. So there is a fight among them, and then all of them try to leave. That time, others survive. As long as prana does not leave, everyone survives. But when prana tried to leave, all of the indriyas also lost their power, and then they were about to, you know, cease to be. Therefore, they said that okay, prana is mukhya there. He is the, you know, mukhya in all these indriyas and karanas. So that's one story we have seen. And elsewhere, when utkramana takes place, when all these indriyas leave the sharira, in that shruti or another shruti, when the indriyas leave, then which all indriyas are mentioned there? Hastadi indriyas are also mentioned. Therefore, utkramane sthite, sapta vyatirikta, the seven that you have counted, other than those sapta vyatirikta indriyanam, hastadi indriyanam, utkramane sthite sati, when they are also going to leave the body in mrityu, or in that story also they have been shown as indriyas separately, they are counted separately from these seven that you have shown, then ataha na evam, and therefore na evam meaning sapta eva and vritti bhedat ekadasha paryantam, that is not right, says the siddhanti to the purvapakshi as well as ekadeshi Vedanti. So tuhu ekadeshi mata nirasartha. Why? Hasto vai graha ityadina hastadayo vyatiriktaha pranaha shruyante. Prana means indriyani. There are other indriyas also. Hastadaya, hastapada ityadi. And they are what? Vyatiriktaha. They are different from these seven that you have counted. In those seven, hasta ityadi is not included. Therefore, saptatva sankhya is not right. Then saptatva sankhyayam asambhavitantar bhave saptatvatireke sthite. Utkramane sthite or saptatva atireke sthite. Other than these seven, when these what? Saptatva sankhyayam asambhavitantar bhave. It is impossible that the vritti bhedas are ones which are counted to 11 and 7 do not include these. So 7 do not include saptatva sankhyam asambhavit antarbhavi. These are not established as being in those 7, which are those hastadi indriyas, karma indriya, other karma indriyas from vak. So when they are separate, saptatva atireke sthite, when they are standing out separate from these 7, then how can you discount them? They have been said to be prana indriyas. So saptatva sankhya ekadashatva sankhyayam antarbhavayetum shakyate. So there purvapakshi says this saptatva sankhya which is there, that saptatva sankhya can include ekadasha, meaning with this 7 you can count the 11 also, they are with various bhedas, we can somehow include them. Ekadashatva sankhyayam antarbhavayetum shakyate, this is still the ekadeshi एक्सप्लेनिंग इन वन वे अतः नैव मंतव्यम. सो दिस कैन बी एकदेशी सूत्र ऑल्सो एज टू एकदेशी इज एक्सप्लेनिंग हाउ दिस कैन बी इंक्लूडेड अदर्स कैन बी इंक्लूडेड. दिस इज इन सप्तत्व 11 कैन बी काउंटेड एंड देन दी अदर्स इफ दी अदर फॉर मनोवृत्ति भेदा कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज टू काउंट टू 11 अप टू 11 8 9 10 11. So there are various methodologies in which we can include whatever is missing in the 7 itself. With the Vritti Bheda, if there are 4 additional and other Indriyas are not included, you can somehow count them in 7 itself. So Shakyate, this is what it says. Ataha na eva mantavyam. So what is he saying? Sapta eva pranaha. To that, you know, the Ekadashatva Sankhyam antar bhavayetum shakyate, he saying. Possible. बट अतः न एवं मंतव्यम. यू शुड नॉट थिंक सप्तैव प्राणः इति मीनिंग देयर आर 7 बट 11 नंबर काउंट कैन ऑल्सो बी इंक्लूडेड. दिस इज द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द पूर्व पक्षी विच इज बीइंग रिफ्यूटेड नाउ सेइंग दैट सप्तैव प्राणः इति न एवं मंतव्यम एवं सूत्रद्वयम् योजनीयम्. सो हाउ शुड दिस टू सूत्रास बी सीन फ्रॉम द परम सिद्धांत पर्सपेक्टिव. सो द प्रोग्रेशन इज मेंशन्ड. Progression of the discussion is mentioned. Purva Pakshi has asked a question, how many are these Indriyas which you have established to be born from Brahma? So Ekadeshi has said 7. What about the 8, 9, 10, 11? So those numbers can also be included by Vritti Bheda. What about the Hasti Indriya? Somehow you can include in the 7, he is saying. So Sutra Dvayam Evam Yojaniyam. In this manner you go through the progression of the 5th and the 6th Sutra of this 4th Pada of 2nd Adhyaya. He says, सप्तैव इंद्रियाणि एकदेशी सप्तैव इंद्रियाणि प्राणं अनुत्क्रामन्तं सर्वे प्राणा अनुत्क्रामन्ति. सो दिस प्राणः प्राणः शब्द इज इंद्रियपर. इट इज इन प्लूरल. इट मीन्स इंद्रियास एंड प्राणं हियर इज दिस मुख्य प्राण इज प्राण द प्राण इन दी विच इज स्वार्थ मीनिंग. सो दिस व्हेन दी प्राण लीव्स दी शरीर or tries to leave the sharira in the story which was, you know, taken up in Chandogya Upanishad as to when they are having fight as to which is the karana which is important. Their pranam anutkramantam sarve prana anutkramanti. Following prana, all these, you know, indriyas also leave. All the karanas leave, pranas, indriyas. इति प्राणादि सप्तानामेव गतेः श्रवणात्. ओनली 7 आर हर्ड देयर. 7 प्राणास 7 इंद्रियास आर हर्ड देयर. देयरफॉर दैट श्रुति टेल्स यू दैट देयर आर 7 इंद्रियास. ननु नाउ द पूर्वपक्षी आस्क्स ननु सर्वशब्द श्रवणात् कथं सप्तानामेवेति तत्राह. सो सर्वे प्राणः हैज बीन मेंशन. सर्वे प्राण मीन्स सर्वे सर्वाणि इंद्रियाणि ऑल इंद्रियास. So in when all indriyas are mentioned, then why do you count only 7? Because there is no 7 number there. Pranam anutkramantam sarve prana anutkramanti. When sarva shabda is there, sarva shabda shravanat katham saptanam eva iti tatraha. How is it that only 7 are counted by you? So there the ekadeshi visheshitatvach. Because such a count is there elsewhere. स यत्र एष चाक्षुषः पुरुषः इत्यादिना चक्षुरादि सप्तानामेव उत्क्रांतौ विशेषतत्वाच्च. सो देयर इज अ काउंट. स यत्र एषः चाक्षुषः पुरुषः चाक्षुषः पुरुषः एंड देन यू गो थ्रू द मंत्र यू काउंट द इंद्रियास देयर यू विल गेट 7 नंबर. देयरफॉर इत्यादि चक्षुरादि सप्तानामेव उत्क्रांतौ विशेषतत्वाच्च. व्हेन दीज इंद्रियास लीव द शरीर or try to leave the sharira in the Chandogya story, then that time you hear only 7. Ataha sarva shabdasya prakruta apekshatvat sapte utkramanti iti prapte. Iti prapte. This is the ekadeshi mata which is prapta as an answer to the purva pakshi. So this is the way the earlier two sutras have to be seen, interpreted. So ataha sarva shabdasya prakruta apekshatvat. In the context, you look at it, sarva shabda, in which context? In the context of pranam anutkramantam, sarve prana anutkramanti. I'm sorry. So there, these दिस सर्व शब्द विल गो टुगेदर विद दी सप्त वेरी वेल, सप्तत्व संख्या, देर बाय सर्व शब्द से प्रकृतापेक्षत्वात् सप्त एव उत्क्रामन्ति. ओनली सेवन आर लीविंग, सेवन इंद्रियाज आर इंक्लूड इन सर्व शब्द इति प्राप्ते इति उत्तर रूपेण एकदेशी वेदांतिनः उत्तर रूपेण प्राप्ते सति उच्यते. उच्यते व्हाट? दिस परम सिद्धांती उच्यते वेदांती सेज हस्तादयोपि अपरे प्राणाः उत्क्रामन्ति. सो हस्तादय, हस्तेन्द्रिया, पादेन्द्रिया, ऑल दीज आर आल्सो टू बी काउंटेड देयर अपरे, दे आर अदर देन दीज सेवन दैट यू हैव बीन शोइंग एज ज्ञानेन्द्रिय इत्यादि. प्राणा उत्क्रामन्ति, इंद्रियास ऑल्सो लीव द शरीरा. हाउ डू यू नो दैट? दशे मे पुरुषे प्राण आत्मेकादशस्ते यदा शुड हैव बीन, आई थिंक यदा, जस्ट लेट मी क्रॉस चेक दिस मंत्र, यद यदा और यद यद दशे मे पुरुषे प्राण आत्मेकादशस्ते. हाँ, यदा ओनली यदा स्म शरीरान मर्त्याद उत्क्रामन्ति अथ रोदयन्ति. सो व्हेन दीज इंद्रियाज लीव, व्हेन इन मरणावस्था, मरणावस्था मीनिंग व्हेन मरणा इज देयर, प्राणा लीव्स, व्हेन प्राणा गोज ऑल द इंद्रियाज ऑल्सो अनुत्क्रामन्ति, दे ऑल्सो फॉलो. सो सर्व शब्द देयर शुड मीन व्हाट? दश इमे पुरुषे प्राण आत्मैकादशस्ते. सो देर आर 10 प्राणास, सॉरी 10 प्राणास मीन 10 इंद्रियाज देर, प्राण पुरुषे प्राण दश, दश इमे दशे इमे दश प्राण. सो देर आर 10 मेंशनड देर एंड देन आत्मा, एंड देन आत्मा ऑल्सो देर आत्मा इज इन मीनिंग ऑफ इंद्रिया इट सेल्फ, देर अंतकरण. सो टोटली हाउ मेनी? 11. दश इमे प्राण पुरुषे, पुरुषे इमे दश प्राण एंड देन आत्मा एकादश, एकादश विथ द अंतकरण दे आर 11 टोटल. एंड ते प्राण दो ते तानि इंद्रियाणि इत्यर्थ. यदा यदा अस्मात् शरीरात् मर्त्याद् उत्क्रामन्ति, व्हेन दे लीव फ्रॉम दिस शरीर, फ्रॉम दिस शरीर, विच शरीर? मर्त्य, मर्त्य शरीर विच हैज गॉट दिस डेथ मीनिंग, विच हैज द मृत्यु इज प्राप्त देर, देन फ्रॉम दैट डेड बॉडी हाउ मेनी इंद्रियाज लीव? एक्चुअली प्राण गोज अवे देन द बॉडी इज डेड एंड दैट टाइम द इंद्रियाज आर ऑल्सो गोइंग. एट दैट मोमेंट वॉट हैपन्स? द 11 इंद्रियाज आर लीविंग, देर फोर अथ रोदयंती एंड देन द अदर्स अराउंड दे स्टार्ट क्राइंग लुकिंग एट द बॉडी, द पर्सन इज डेड नाउ. सो इन दैट मंत्र 11 हैव बीन काउंटेड एज इंद्रियाज इति एकादशानां प्राणानां उत्क्रांति श्रवणात्. एकादश, 11 आर नोन इन दैट मंत्र. प्राणास मीन्स इंद्रियास हियर. सो प्राणानां उत्क्रांति श्रवणात्, इंद्रियाणां उत्क्रांति श्रवणात् सर्वेषाम् एव उत्क्रमणे स्थिते सति. When all these are mentioned, then hastendriya ityadi are mentioned there. Then sthite sati na evam. Na evam means you should not say only seven are there. That is not correct. Says the siddhanti to ekadeshi vedanti. Sapte eva iti na. Iti evam na. Tasmat na shruti naam mitho virodha iti siddham. Therefore there is no virodha. Sometimes you know karmendriyas are not counted. Sometimes they are counted. Therefore, it is not that seven. You should not say seven. There are 11 indriyas, but seven are mentioned at some places, others are not mentioned. Just because others are not mentioned, you cannot say there are only seven. In the context, only seven were needed to be mentioned. They have been mentioned. There was no focus on the other indriyas. Just like in Trivitkaranam and Panchikaranam, three are mentioned, other two are not mentioned, which is fine. That does not mean there is a virodha. So, tasmat na shruti na mitho virodha iti siddham. There is no mutual contradiction among these saptatva, ashtatva ityadi shruti. Nanu indriyanam utkrantir na sambhavati. Now, the Purvapakshi is saying this mantra that you have brought in as to when the person dies, that time jiva dies, any sharira, person may not be person, it can be any animal itself. So when the, but mukhya discussion, when you see, look at the rodanti, the others cry, rodayanti, they make the rodayanti. So rodayanti means atha rodayanti, it is causative, it is hetumati. So it's a nijanta, looks like a nijanta, rodayanti, these pranaha, atha rodayanti, because in the same, pranaha is a pranaha rodayanti, these indriyas leaving the dead body make the relatives cry. So here, that shruti has been quoted by the Siddhanti, Vedanti. Now Purva Pakshi asks, what do you mean by indriyas leaving the sharira? What does that shruti mean there? So the indriyas leaving the body makes no sense to me, he says. So there is some shruti, when you look at some shruti, it appears as though indriyas are vibhu. And leaving the sharira, indriyas leaving the sharira shows you that indriyas are limited. So there is a virodha there also. So he says, anu indriyanam utkrantirna sambhavati. Indriyas leaving the sharira, that itself is not possible. You are taking the meaning from the shruti, that itself is not possible. Why? Tesham aparichinna ahankara janyatvena vibhutvad. Iti akshepa sangatya idamaha. There is an akshepa by the Purva Pakshi. He is objecting to this interpretation of the shruti. So Sankhya say there is, you know, the mahatattva. Mahatattva is ahankara. So mahatattva and then ahankara, and then there is this, you know, the we have seen earlier as to the prakriti, vikriti, and prakriti, vikriti both. So there are some paramakarana which does not have any karana, like pradhana, and then in between there are multiple stages which are karyas also and karanas also. So prakriti also and vikriti also. And the end products are only vikrutis, only karyas, they are not karanas. So this is the hierarchy of the sankhyas, which we agree with, you know, superficially, hypothetically, as a basis of discussion, we agree in some form, agree with some kind of a division there. But when they say that these indriyas are, he says, tesham aparichinna ahankara janyatvena. This ahankara, which is the universal intellectual principle, that gives rise to these indriyas. So these indriyas are aparichinna ahankara janyatvena vibhu. They are vibhu. These indriyas are vibhu. They are not anu. Meaning they are not limited. They are limitless. And the limitless indriyas cannot leave from the limited body by themselves being limited. The body is limited. Indriyas are limitless. How will they leave the body? So all this is incorrect interpretation by the Vedanti, says the Purva Pakshi. Iti akshepa sangatya idamaha. Thereby sangati is akshepa sangati. There is a aropa made here. And thereby prana anutvadhikaranam. So pranas, indriyas are anu. That adhikarana comes up anavascha. Anavascha, says Bhagavan Sutrakara. Anavahacha. Anu, anu limited. These pranas, indriyas are anu. Anu means what? They are sukshma. So by sukshmatva you have misunderstood vibhutva. But just because they are sukshma does not mean they are vibhu. They are anu. They are limited. Indriyas definitely leave the body. They are not overreaching the body. They are not there everywhere. So this is the reply to the Purva Pakshi's akshepa. Atra utkrantyadi shrutehe pranaha sarve anantaha iti indriya vibhutva shrutya virodha asti nava iti sandehe virodha asti iti Purva Pakshaha. Purva Pakshi has not made his his darshana from nowhere. There is some basis. There is a lot of misinterpretation, but there is a basis to that misinterpretation. Shruti can be seen, something can be traced back to Shruti, and a justification can be made from the perspective of the Sankhya Darshanika also. So what do they say? Pranaha sarve anantaha, sarve pranaha anantaha. दे आर अनंता साक्षात श्रुति इज देयर. सो ही सेज सर्वे प्राणः अनंताः दैट काइंड ऑफ श्रुति इज देयर. अत्र उत्क्रांत्यादि श्रुतेः प्राणाः सर्वे अनंताः इति इंद्रिय विभुत्व श्रुत्या विरोधः अस्ति न वा इति संदेहे. उत्क्रांति श्रुति हैव शोन व्हिच इज दैट दि दशे मे पुरुषे प्राण आत्मैकादशस्ते यदास्मा शरीरान् मर्त्याद् उत्क्रामन्ति अथ रोदयन्ति. दैट इज उत्क्रांति श्रुति. सो देर यू आर सेइंग इंद्रियाज आर बिकॉज इंद्रियाज आर हैविंग उत्क्रमण एंड उत्क्रमण कैन बी ओनली देर फॉर अ लिमिटेड फॉर द लिमिटेड इंद्रियाज. दे कैन नॉट बी लिमिटलेस. They cannot be vibhu. They have to be anu. And then pranaha sarve anantaha. Ananta ananta prana. Ananta prana shows vibhutva of indriyas. Pranaha meaning indriyas. They are ananta. So prana sarve anantaha iti indri vibhutva shrutya. One is utkranti shruti is talking about indriyas which are anu. Whereas this prana sarve ananta is a indriya vibhutva shruti. So indriya vibhutva shruti is opposed to indriya anutva shruti by meaning utkranti shruti. So utkranti shruti, which is anutva shruti, indriya anutva shruti and indriya vibhutva shruti, both are contradictory to each other. Thereby virodha asti navaiti sandehe. When such sandeha comes up, doubt, virodha asti, the purva paksha, it is clear that there is virodha between the two. Siddhantastu, Siddhanti says no, there is no virodha. Why? Ime prana anavaha parichinnaha. Anavaha, they are parichinna, they are limited. Pranas, indriyas are limited. These indriyas, why? Indriya agrahyatvena sukshmatvat. What is the meaning there as to what that ananta, meaning the indriya vibhutva shruti, we'll see. But what is the real meaning? The utkranti shruti has shown anutva and indriyas are not indriya grahya. Indriyas are used to know the vishayas. They help you in the grahana of the vishayas, but indriyas themselves cannot be grasped by indriyas. Therefore indriya, you can see indriya golakas, others indriya golakas you can see, some of the indriya golakas of yours you can see, some indriya golakas you cannot see, meaning the eyes cannot see the eyes. So indriya golakas also are not visible, but vishayas are visible. Indriyas themselves are not visible. How will you know your indriyas? How will you grasp your indriyas? You cannot know this is my indriya. You can know this is my indriya golaka, you cannot know this is my indriya through the indriyas. Therefore indriya agrahyatvena kesham prananam, prananam indriyanam indriya agrahyatvena sukshmatvam. Definitely they are subtle. Indriyas are subtle. Why? Hetu is what? They cannot be grasped by indriyas. Whatever can be grasped by indriyas is not subtle. Is only gross forms can be known, gross sound can be heard and so on. But indriyas themselves, Shrotriendriya cannot be heard. The Chakshurendriya cannot be seen. The Twagendriya cannot be felt. Rasenendriya cannot be tasted. And Ghranendriya cannot be smelled. You cannot smell. Therefore, they are sukshma. Indriyas are sukshma. They are anu. Anu meaning sukshma. They are sukshma. And what is sukshma need not be vibhu. So you are misinterpreting this sukshmatva as vibhutva. Then Purvapakshi, what about this prana sarve anantaha? There is no anantaha shabda is there. Ananta does not mean sukshma there. So they are sukshma all right. But what tells you that they are not vibhu, because prana sarve ananta, what about that mantra? So to that the Siddhanti says vibhutva shrute he, this vibhutva shruti prana sarve ananta ha, that shruti is upasana para. It is to be used for upasana, it is not literal. So vibhutva shrute he upasana paratvat na taya utkrantyadi shrute shrute he virodha iti siddham. There is a repha missing there. So utkranti shruti virodha isn't there, because the vibhutva shruti is telling you how to do a particular upasana. That is the upasana kanda. In upasana kanda, what is there? That is all to be made a kalpana of. There is a kalpana to be made. It is not that प्राणाज इंद्रियाज आर रियली अनंता मीनिंग दे आर रियली अपरिच्छिन्न और विभू बट दे आर ओनली फॉर द उपासना एंड देयर बाय देयर इज नो विरोध बिटवीन द विभुत्व श्रुति एंड द उत्पत्ति श्रुति उत्पत्ति मीनिंग इंद्रिय उत्पत्ति श्रुति और उत्पत्ति इंद्रिय उत्क्रांति इंद्रिय उत्क्रांति उत्क्रांति श्रुति और इंद्रिय उत्क्रांति श्रुति देयर इज नो विरोध बिटवीन दैट एंड द विभुत्व श्रुति सो देयर बाय विभुत्व श्रुते हे उपासना परत्वात् न तया उत्क्रांत्यादि श्रुते हे सो देयर इज अ रेफा मिसिंग श्रुतेर विरोध न इति सिद्धम इट इज देयर इज नो विरोध बिटवीन द टू इत्थम मुख्य प्राण अतिरिक्त प्राणानां सृष्ट्यादिकं शिष्ट्वा मुख्य अपि प्राणे प्रथमाधिकरण न्यायम अतिदिशति सो इत्थम इन दिस मैनर मुख्य प्राण अतिरिक्त प्राणानाम द मुख्य प्राण इज ऑल्सो कारण एंड अतिरिक्त प्राण आर इंद्रिया सो अदर देन द मुख्य प्राण द अदर प्राण विच आर इंद्रिया इन द मीनिंग ऑफ इंद्रिया दे ऑल्सो हैव सृष्टि फ्रॉम ब्रह्म दे ऑल्सो मीनिंग एज अपोज टू वॉट एज अपो अदर देन द भूत पंचमहाभूत विच हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड इन द थर्ड पादा सो पंचमहाभूताज आर बॉर्न फ्रॉम ब्रह्म देर फोर ब्रह्मणी समन्वय अस्थि देन दीज मुख्य प्राण अतिरिक्त प्राणाज आर इंद्रियाज इंद्रियाज आर भौतिकाज दे आर प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ भूताज दे आर एलिमेंटल्स बॉर्न आउट ऑफ द पंचमहाभूता एलिमेंट्स देर फोर दे आर ऑल्सो बॉर्न फ्रॉम ब्रह्म हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश समन्वय सिद्धि इन द थर्ड पादा beginning itself we have opened in that manner not the third pada fourth pada now this mukhya prana what about mukhya prana you have talked about pranas indriyas which are other than mukhya prana what about mukhya prana does it have utpatti or not and if there is a utpatti is it born from brahma that is the question to be resolved thereby the prana shreshtyadikaranam comes up. Ittha mukhya prana atirkta pranam srishtyadikam shishtva. Having established, taught that the indriyas other than mukhya pranas, pranas other than mukhya prana, meaning indriyas other than mukhya prana, are also born from Brahma just like the bhutas. So bhautika indriyas just like bhutas are also born from Brahma. Then having done that, what is the sutrakara doing? Mukhya api prane prathama adhikarana nyayam atirishati. The prathama adhikarana in the fourth pada itself, tatha pranaha, in that sutra was prana utpatti adhikarana. So prana utpatti adhikarana has used some nyaya, the same nyaya is extended to the mukhya prana. There prana was in the sense of indriya. So indriya utpatti adhikarana was the first adhikarana in the fourth pada. Whatever was the nyaya used there, that is extended here, atidesha. So there is no prathak sangati apeksha because it is an extension of the sangati which was already given. The same nyaya is being used. Whatever was used in the first adhikarana, the same is being used here in the fourth adhikarana. Therefore, there is no separate sangati given. Shreshtascha, shreshtascha, says this shruti. What is shreshtascha? Shreshtascha, shreshta means mukhya. So shreshtascha pranaha, mukhyascha pranaha. और मुख्य प्राणश्च ब्रह्मण जायते जस्ट लाइक एतस्मात् जायते प्राण देयर प्राण सो प्राण इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम ब्रह्म जस्ट लाइक इंद्रियाज आर बॉर्न फ्रॉम ब्रह्म जस्ट लाइक खम वायु इत्यादि पंचमहाभूताज आर बॉर्न फ्रॉम ब्रह्म सो वेरी सिंपल सूत्र अतिदेशत्वात् न पृथक संगत्यपेक्षा बिकॉज ऑफ अतिदेश एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दि सेम न्याय So same sangati also holds which was there in the first adhikarana. Another sangati is not needed. Atra etasma jayate prana iti mukhya pranotpatti shrute he anida vatam iti shrute prak mahapralaya prana sadbhava shrutya virodha asti nava iti sande he asti iti purva paksha. This should be a single word here. Sadbhava shrutya, it should be a single word. There is no space in between. So what is the siddhanti saying Mukhya Prana is also born from Brahma. Why so? There is a Virodha, says the Purva Pakshi. Now the Etasma Jayate Pranaha, this mantra we have seen earlier, Mundaka mantra, that was shown as what? Indriyotpatti Shruti. Because it said Etasma Jayate Pranaha Manaha Sarvendriyani Cha. So Indriyotpatti Shruti, and not only that, Prana Shabda is there, therefore it is Mukhya Prana Utpatti Shruti also. Mana Shabda is there, it is Manotpatti Shruti also. And then Mana Utpatti Shruti also, and then Kham Vayu Ityadi are there in the second half of the mantra, Mundaka mantra, therefore it is also Bhuta Utpatti Shruti. So based on which is the context, that kind of a word is given to the Shruti, Visheshana is added. So Mukhya Prana Utpatti Shruti, why? Because Prana is in the meaning of Mukhya Prana there. So Etasma Jayate Prana Iti Mukhya Utpatti Shruti He. That Shruti talks about Pranaha, Etasmad Brahmana Jayate, Mukhya Pranaha. And then Anida Vatam, there is another Shruti says the Purva Pakshi. Wait, do not jump to conclusion. Anida Vatam. Anida Vatam is a Shruti. Iti Shrishtev Prak Mahapralaye Prana Sadbhava Shrutya. Prana Sadbhava, Prana was there when Shrishtev Prak. Before the Shrishti, Prana was there. Why? Because Anid Avatam. The Padachheda of that mantra is Anid Avatam. Avatam. Avatam means Vata is has the meaning of Prana. So Avatam Anid. It says Avata. Avata Anid. So and Ana. This Anid is a form. It is a verb form. Anid. Was there. What was there? Avatam meaning this dhatu is anapranane. So it existed. What existed? Avatam existed. It existed in some form. Prana was there. Iti srishtev prak mahapralaya. After mahapralaya means in mahapralaya avastha before the srishti of the next kalpa prana sadbhava shrutya. Prana was there. Because what is said? Avata. Vata is not in the meaning of Vata, is in the meaning of Vayu. Sorry, Vayu. So Anit means this the dhatu here. This dhatu is in the meaning of prana. Anit. Anit means prana was there. Prana was there because it is Bhutakala. So it is Bhutakala. Sorry, was there, who was there? Prana was there. Ana pranane. So prana was there is the meaning of anit. And how was prana there? Avatam. Avatam means vayu rahita. So vata, vayu wasn't there. And it was there without vayu. Meaning what? Prana was there. Anit. When Shrishtev Prak, before Shrishti in Pralayavastha, Mahapralaya, at that time, prana was there without vayu. That is the shruti. Now, you have quoted etasma jayate pranaha. And then another shruti I am quoting, anidavatam. Between them, meaning pranaha, etasmat brahmana jayate, and avatam, anit, pranaha, was there. Asit, srishtev prak asit, pranaha asit. Anit means pranaha asit. When srishtev prak, how? Avatam, vayu rahitam, pranaha. Srishtev prak asit, that is the meaning there. And etasmat brahmanaha prana jayate is another shruti meaning. So these shrutis, both shrutis have virodha, contradictory among each other. That's what I am objecting to, says the Purva Pakshi, showing the virodha there. So iti virodha astinava, prana sadbhava shruti is there, and then prana utpatti shruti. Here we have mukhya prana utpatti shruti, and then prana sadbhava shruti. Both have virodha. Asthiti Purva Paksha, Virodha is definitely there. Siddhantastu. Siddhanti says, no, there is no Virodha. Why? Shreshtascha. Indriyavata Shreshto Api Pranaha Brahmana Jayate. Just like Indriyas, the Shreshta Mukhya Prana is also born from Brahma. Then what about this anidavatam? So ataha anidavatam iti shrutau anid shabdaha karana sadbhavam darshayati. Avatam prana rahitam iti visheshanat. So what does he say? Siddhanti says, you are reading avatam. So I explain this, anidavatam I explain as the vata shabda as the meaning of prana. But Purvapakshi is not pointing that. Siddhanti says this vata shabda, there you are saying vayu rahita prana was there, but that is not the meaning there. What is the meaning? This prana was avatam, meaning it was not there, the karana was there. Prana karana anit, that karana rupa prana anit, and avatam meaning that prana, prana rahita prana was there. So what was there? Prana rahita meaning avyakrita, that prana was avyakrita, that is the meaning there. So iti ataha anidavatam iti shrutau anit shabda, that anit shabda which is there, that is karana sadbhavam darshiti. It shows the karana being there, not that nothing was there, as in prana was there. It does not show, it does not show that prana was there without vayu. It shows that prana was there without prana, meaning it was there in the sukshma avastha, it was there in the karana avastha. So karana sadbhavam darshayati avatam prana rahitam iti visheshana, because it is saying that avatam means what? Not vayu rahitam, prana rahitam. And prana rahitam prana asit, and now shreshtascha prana utpadyate by etasma jayate prana. So prana is born from the karana avastha into karya avastha, that is the meaning there. And thereby both shrutis can be seen with samanvaya in brahma as karana. Avatam prana rahitam iti visheshanat. So karana was there, anit karana was there, that prana anit, that anapranane, there it means that something was there. Something was there before. What was that? Brahma was there. So prana was there in karana brahma avastha, and now after that avata stage it has become savata stage, meaning it has taken the form of being manifest as prana, which is helping the vyavahara. Therefore etasma jayate prana has no virodha with anidavatam. Na taya shrutya pranotpatti shrutehe virodha iti siddham. There is no virodha of this shruti with the, this shruti means anidavatam shruti, with the etasma jayate prana iti pranotpatti shruti. So that pranotpatti shrutehe virodha nasti, that pranotpatti shruti does not have virodha with this shruti, that is showing the, as per you, it is showing the prana being there, but prana was not there, brahma was there. Sadbhava of brahma is shown and prana is included there in unmanifested. Iti siddham. Therefore, there is no virodha. We'll stop here and we'll continue in the next part. Today is Mangal. Today is Tuesday. So, today is Purnima also. So, tomorrow is Prathama and then Thursday we have an off anyway, so I'll see you on Friday. From Friday onwards we'll have a 45 minutes class, 6 to 6:45, and then because I'm starting another Vichara Sagara in Hindi, so we'll have the patha reduced to 45 minutes. Today I wanted to have samskar of 45 minutes, but somehow I went over the 45 minutes time. So let me set an alarm for other days as to stop after 45 minutes. नमस्ते धन्यवाद आम्नाय समसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंदघनम अपूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद.